Irish trees. Mendelssohn 1. Mendelssohn number 1. I'm not. yelling because I know if I yell, it's going to go through there.
What? You used to just go for it.
All right, Mendelssohn first.
Thank you. I hereby call to order the 142nd commencement exercises for Bridgewater College. Good morning. As Grand Marshal, I am pleased to welcome you to Bridgewater College and our commencement exercises for the class of 2022. Please give Dr. Christine Carrillo and the Bridgewater College Symphonic Band, as well as our bagpiper, Kathy Boyer, a round of applause for the wonderful music this morning. Please remain standing, and gentlemen, please remove your caps for the invocation to be offered by members of the class of 2022.
Let us bow our heads and pray. Gracious and loving God, as we gather on this special day, we thank you for the class of 2022 and each remarkable member of it. And as the memorial bell reminds them of the events and victories of their years at BC, may it forever ring in their hearts as these eagles take flight. Be with us as we celebrate our seniors this day and make them a blessing to this world you so love. Amen.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته يا رب العالمين يا عزيز يا رحيم أحمدك بهذا اليوم المميز على حسن توفيقك لنا ويجب التذكرة بأنه لولا الدعاء ما زالت الصعاب والنتيجة والتخرج أكمل الطعم هذه المسيرة العظيمة زملائي وأصدقائي الأعزاء خلال تجمعنا اليوم أشكر الله على دفعة عام 2022 حيث رنت جرس ميموريال تذكرنا بالأوقات الجميلة التي قضيناها سوياً والانتصارات التي حققناها سوياً خلال سنواتنا في جامعة بريدجواتر كوليدج أتمنى أن يبقى هذا الجرس يرن في قلوبنا بعد أن نحلق من هذه الجامعة كالنسور أتمنى لكم الإبداع والتميز في كل وقت حتى تشرق وتعلو البلاد بكم وبأمثالكم من العظماء آمين
Dieu de tous les peuples, de toutes les nations et de toutes les cultures, nous te remercions pour le Collège de Bridgewater et sa mission d'éduquer la personne dans sa globalité, qui est esprit, corps et âme. Nous te remercions pour ce jour et tout ce qui signifie pour ceux qui sont ici dans leur corps et ceux qui sont ici dans leur esprit. Sois avec nous alors que nous célébrons nos aînés en ce jour et fais de nous une bénédiction pour ce monde que tu aimes tant. Amen.
Dios bondadoso y amoroso, al reunirnos en este día especial, le damos las gracias por la clase de 2022 y por cada uno de sus notables miembros. Y miembros de la campana conmemorativa, les recuerdo los eventos y las victorias de sus años en BC. Que siempre suenen sus corazones mientras altas águilas levanten el vuelo. Acompáñenos mientras celebramos a nuestros mayores en este día y haz que sean una bendición para este mundo que tanto amas. Amén.
Bon Dieu qui tient pitié à Clermont, pour une appréciable nos jours spéciaux, ça, nous remercions pour toute classe 2022 à chaque monde remarquable qu'il a donné. Et puis, pour la cloche mémoriale là, absonnée, faisons songer événement avec toi qui est vivant dans l'école, ça. Zoiseau à provol, mais les absonnés pour tout temps, nos cailloux. Restez avec nous pour un célébrement finissant ça aujourd'hui. Et puis, faisons tourner en bénédiction pour le monde, ça, qui est remis en pile là. Amen.
Милосърден и любящ Господи, докато се събираме в този специален ден, ние ти благодарим за класа на 2022 година и всеки забележителен член от него. И докато камбаната на мемориала им напомня за събитията и победите от годините, в им в колежа на Bridgewater, нека вечно звъни в сърцата им, като полетат тези орли. Бъди с нас, като празнуваме на този ден завършването на абсолвентите, в благословия този свят, който толкова обичаш. Амин.
Please be seated. At this time, it is my distinct privilege to introduce to you the president of Bridgewater College, Dr. David Bushman.
Thank you, Dr. Albers. On behalf of our faculty and staff, it's an honor to welcome all of you to the 142nd commencement exercises of Bridgewater College. It's now my pleasure to introduce to you the members of our platform party. I'll start with several individuals who give unselfishly of their time, their talent, and their treasure in stewarding Bridgewater College through their service on our Board of Trustees. I'll ask them to stand, and please hold your applause until I have introduced all of the trustees who are here today. Mr. Bruce Christian, Chair of the Board. Mr. Menzel Dean, the Reverend Paul Mundy, Mr. Jeff Postens, and Ms. Kathy Wright. Thank you all. Next, I'd like to recognize members of the senior leadership team of the college who are with us today. Again, please hold your applause until all the vice presidents have been introduced. Dr. Leona Sevick, Provost and Executive Vice President. Mr. Kurt Kendall, our Director of Athletics. Mr. Michael Post, Vice President for Enrollment Management. Mrs. Christy Ray, Vice President for Information Technology and Chief Information Officer. And Dr. Leslie Frere, Vice President for Student Life and our Dean of Students, who is with our students today. Thank you all. Finally, the remaining members of the platform party will be introduced now. Please, again, hold your applause until I've introduced them. First, Mr. Brad Halleck. He's the president of the Bridgewater College Alumni Association. The Reverend Dr. Robbie Miller, our campus chaplain. And our registrar, Mrs. Cynthia Haldyshell Shull. Please join me in recognizing their many contributions to the college and the important role they play in today's ceremony. As we start, I want to say just a few words about our faculty and staff. The distinctiveness of a college, and certainly of Bridgewater College, and the success of its students depends on the talent and the dedication of the faculty. The Bridgewater faculty is certainly talented and dedicated, and it's a privilege to serve alongside of them. It's always the case that the success of our academic community depends on the quality of classroom teaching and of the scholarly and professional accomplishment of the faculty. But over the last few months, it required something more, something unimaginable. The commitment and care you have demonstrated for our students and for each other and for the well-being of the college as a whole has been profound. Very little about this year has been easy, but you persevered as teachers, as scholars, and as mentors. Your work has provided the foundation upon which our students will engage new ideas and challenge their received wisdom, an effort that must occur if they are to discover their potential to excel. More than ever, this year, you have served as role models for our students to emulate. To our graduates, I urge you to consider well the efforts of this faculty on your behalf. They have guided you to this moment, and they expect much of you in the years to come. You can honor their work best by striving to live as they do in service to others. I'd ask all of us present, and especially our students, to join me now in a moment of recognition for the ongoing and exceptional work of our faculty. Finally, there are many, many people who were instrumental in the success of our graduates, but who are rarely in the spotlight. Our staff display the same dedication and commitment as our faculty, but their efforts are outside the classroom. The breadth of operations required to make a college work is too great to list here, but the work of our faculty in the classroom would not be possible without the great work of our staff outside the classroom. Every single staff member has played a necessary role in the success and well-being of our students, and especially in this year. Like our faculty, you have turned yourselves inside out on behalf of our students. Many of our staff are here today helping to make this event a success. I'd ask us all to join me in a moment of recognition for the ongoing and exceptional work of our staff. There are two staff members who are not here today, though I'm confident they are with us in spirit. All the members of our Department of Campus Police and Safety make a promise that they will put themselves between us and any danger. John Painter and J.J. Jefferson kept that promise on February 1st, placing themselves in harm's way and sacrificing their lives for us. I think the best way to honor the sacrifice that John and J.J. made, and the best way to remember them, is to understand ourselves what they so clearly knew, that our lives are worth it. They sacrificed their lives so that we could live ours. They have given us the opportunity and the very best example of how to make a difference. I'd ask us all now to observe a moment of silence for campus police officer John Painter and campus safety officer Vashon J.J. Jefferson. Thank you. It's now my pleasure to introduce the chair of the Board of Trustees of Bridgewater College and the parent of a 2006 BC graduate to deliver greetings on behalf of the board. Please welcome to the podium Mr. Bruce Christian.
Thank you, President Bushman. Wow, this is a great day to be at Bridgewater College. Looking out and seeing all of these faces, good morning. I am pleased to bring greetings and congratulations on behalf of the Board of Trustees of Bridgewater College. I extend a warm welcome to all of the families, friends, alumni, staff, and faculty here today to celebrate and to continue the 142-year tradition that is Bridgewater College. I particularly want to welcome you, our outstanding class of 2022. We are gathered under this tent to mark and to celebrate this milestone in your life journey. You have accomplished a remarkable achievement under the most unbelievable circumstances. These are extraordinary times, and extraordinary times create extraordinary people. You are part of a great community of caring individuals that is Bridgewater College. Each of you is different from the person you were when you first arrived here on campus. BC has embraced you, has challenged you, has stretched you, and I dare say at times perhaps exasperated you. Yet you have been resilient. You have stayed the course. You have persevered and are preparing to go out into the world today a success and a special soul. You have been true to your values no matter what the obstacle. And we are all different. Read that as better for your having been here with us. No matter how far you stray, remember you will always have a home here at BC. The education that you received at Bridgewater will benefit you, your family, and your wider community in ways that you can scarcely imagine as you sit under this tent decked out in your cap and gown. I would simply ask that you take the time to reflect upon those who have helped you get to this place, both here and at home, for you are blessed. At Founders Day, I said to you that we are connected, you are connected, to all the generations who have walked across a stage like this, and to those who will follow your similar path. As eagles, we are formed to soar. May you be ever mindful of this gift as you take flight and fly to change and lead the world. Congratulations, and God bless you.
Thank you, Bruce. Next, we have greetings from the president of the Bridgewater College Alumni Association, Mr. Brad Halleck, from the class of 86. It turns out that Brad is more deeply connected to the institution than just his graduation year. His wife, his two daughters, his mother, his father, his grandmother, his aunt, his uncle, and a grandmother have all been part of Bridgewater College tradition and are all alumni. That's a connection to the college that spans 11 decades. Please join me in welcoming to the podium the president of the Alumni Association, Mr. Brad Halleck.
Well, good morning, everyone. On behalf of the more than 15,000 alumni from around the world, I bring greetings and congratulations to you, the class of 2022. Graduates, you have seen over the last few years that some things in life are certainly not certain. You've persevered through the challenges of a global pandemic and the aftermath of the tragic events of February 1st. The responses to those major events reinforced for me that we are exactly the community I always knew we were and that we will continue to be. We are connected. We care for and we support each other. As alumni, you will now call upon the critical skills you developed at BC. While here, you created new ways to learn. You pushed yourselves to explore new concepts. You embraced the value of diversity of backgrounds and ideas. And you became leaders by understanding the power of connection and collaboration. The strength of our connections allows great things to happen, but staying connected does take some effort. I encourage you to stay connected to BC, and there are many ways to remain engaged after today. Make sure you're registered on Bridgewater Connect, our online community. Stay in touch with your classmates, teammates, professors, and coaches. Keep your contact information at the college updated. Consider ways you might volunteer. Maybe come back and help the next class of freshmen on move-in day. And of course, come back for homecoming. I invite you to be an active part of one of the most unique and exclusive communities, a group of individuals who wear crimson and gold with pride. You are one of us. It is my honor and privilege to officially welcome you into the Bridgewater College Alumni Association. Together, we remain BC strong. Thank you.
Thank you, Brad. And thank you also for all of your good work as the president of the Alumni Association. You provide a wonderful example of alumni engagement and care for your alma mater. Greetings from the graduate program candidates will now be offered by Mary Monaco. She's an undergraduate alum from the class of 21 and is receiving her Master of Arts in Digital Media Strategy this year. She's from Fishersville, Virginia. Mary?
Hello, graduates, family, friends, faculty, and staff. I am so honored to be speaking to you today, and I want to begin by addressing a question I believe has been on all of our minds. What comes next? Today, we celebrate that we have completed an education based on Bridgewater's founding values of goodness, truth, beauty, and harmony. Every day after today, we will have both the opportunity and the responsibility to use our education and make the world better. In our time at Bridgewater, we have seen some of the worst that the world has to offer, but we have also seen true goodness. After today, we will no longer be observers. It will be on us to stand up for each other, to build connections, and to support our communities in the way that those things have been demonstrated to us here. We must also value truth. At Bridgewater, we have adopted standards of accountability for ourselves, for our peers, and for our governing institutions. Carry those standards forward. We should also remember to seek out beauty. For many of us, beauty is found in the connections that we've made here. Now, we can seek out and create beauty in new places. Finally, we must strive for harmony. We move out into a world that is divided, but education is a bridge that can carry us over that division. As we move on to new experiences, I encourage each of us to prioritize harmony by listening more than we talk, by trying to learn more than we try to teach, and by working to develop shared understanding, especially with those who are different from us. To the administration, faculty, and staff, thank you. You've brought your support of the Bridgewater community and the class of 2022 to new heights this year. To those I've had the pleasure of working with in the business department and during my undergraduate experience, in the equestrian programs, and in the Master of Digital Media Strategy program, thank you for making my time at Bridgewater absolutely exceptional. To the class of 2022, congratulations on an incredible achievement. Remember our values, represent Bridgewater proudly, and let's go make the world a better place. I can't wait to see what we do next.
Thanks, Mary. Claire Ashley from the class of 22, the senior class president, will now offer greetings on behalf of this year's undergraduate graduating class. She's a nutritional science major from Culpeper, Virginia. Claire?
Hello, friends and classmates. I am honored to be speaking in front of you today. Many people say that today is the day we start our journey, but I completely disagree. The journey began a long time ago. Today just happens to be the day where the path we have been traveling on splits into all different paths. Up until now, we have been going through this journey together, and now it is time for us to part ways. The accomplishments we have made and the things we have been through in the past 4 years are what has prepared us for the real world. Before we graduate, it is my pleasure to introduce to you our senior class gift. We will be donating money raised from fundraisers to the John Painter and J.J. Jefferson Student Support Fund. And again, congratulations to all of you, and I wish you nothing but the best on your future endeavors.
Thank you, Claire. Finally, Lauren I., Bridgewater College, the 2022 Bridgewater College Founders Award winner, will offer her reflections. Lauren is a health and exercise science major from Fredericksburg, Virginia. Lauren?
Hello, soon-to-be graduates of Bridgewater College. It is my honor to be speaking here today. To say that this has been a super simple 4 years would be lying to you all. We have seen it all, but I'm not going to go into detail about that. We have been through a lot, and we've survived going through not being able to see each other in different dormitories and not being able to really be outside together. We've overcome all of these obstacles and we have shared experiences both good and bad and probably seen some people on their worst days. But today, we are the thing that we have been striving towards for so long. I haven't had the pleasure of meeting every single human here, but I do know that you have mattered and you will continue to matter to your friends, your family, your future colleagues, your future students that you might go to grad school with, and amongst so many others. I'm just one person here on this momentous day that is graduation, and I am incredibly proud of everyone. Congratulations and good luck on the endeavors that you are about to embark on. Thank you.
Thank you, Laura, and all those members of the BC community for their thoughtful greetings and remarks this morning. And now the Bridgewater College Symphonic Band will provide our special music composed by BC alum Gary Fagan from the class of 73.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Carrillo. At a college that values leadership and service as we do, it's entirely appropriate to recognize individuals whose dedication and contributions have had a significant impact on the communities they serve. The President's Medal is bestowed upon individuals who have demonstrated exemplary leadership and service to their communities, whether they be around the corner or around the world. Today, we recognize four faculty members who, over their careers, serve the Bridgewater College community and many others with dedication and care. I'd ask Provost Sevick to join me now as we recognize these four retired faculty members who have been granted emeritus status by the Bridgewater College Board of Trustees.
Dr. Joseph M. Crockett earned a Bachelor of Science in Mathematics from Hampton-Sydney College in 1973 and a PhD in Organic and Organometallic Chemistry from the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill in 1979. Dr. Crockett became Assistant Professor of Chemistry at Bridgewater College in 1985, rising to Associate Professor in 1990 and to professor in 1994. He was named the A. Leroy and Wanda H. Baker Professor of Science in 2015 and received the Martha B. Thornton Faculty Recognition Award from the college in 2017. It is with great pleasure and pride that we honor Dr. Joe Crockett today with the President's Medal, awarded by the President in recognition of his 35 years of dedicated service. Dr. Stephen Longenecker faithfully served Bridgewater College as a member of the faculty since 1989. He earned a Bachelor of Science in Secondary Education from Shippensburg University in 1973, a Master of Arts in History from West Virginia University in 1975, a Master of Arts in History in 1987, and a PhD in 1989 from the Johns Hopkins University. Dr. Longenecker rose to associate professor in 1996 and to professor in 2000. He was named the Edwin L. Turner Distinguished Professor of History in 2015. He received the Martha B. Thornton Faculty Recognition Award from the college in 2003 and the college's Faculty Scholarship Award in 2011. In recognition of his 32 years of devoted service to the college as a faculty member and distinguished scholar, we honor Dr. Stephen Longenecker with the President's Medal. Dr. Mwizenge Tembo, Professor of Sociology, came to Bridgewater College as a member of the faculty in 1990. He earned a Bachelor of Arts in Sociology and Psychology from the University of Zambia in 1976, a Master of Arts in 1980, and a PhD in 1987 from Michigan State University. Dr. Tembo was professor and research fellow in sociology at the Institute for African Studies of the University of Zambia from 1980 to 1990, and the head of the Division for Culture Research at the Institute for African Studies at the University of Zambia from 1987 to 1990. He was awarded tenure at Bridgewater College in 1994, rose to associate professor in 1998 and rose to professor in 2010. In recognition of his 31 years of dedicated service to the college as a member of the faculty, we honor Dr. Mwizenge Tembo with the President's Medal. Dr. Alice Troop, Professor of English, has served Bridgewater College as a member of the faculty since 1997. She earned a Bachelor of Arts in English in 1971, a Master of Arts in English in 1979, and a PhD in Rhetoric and Linguistics in 1996, all from the Indiana University of Pennsylvania. She was promoted to Associate Professor in 2002, and to professor in 2018, and she served as the college's Director of Composition and Director of the Writing Center from 1997 until her retirement. Dr. Troop received the Martha B. Thornton Faculty Recognition Award from the college in 2008. In recognition of her 24 years of dedicated service to the college as a member of the faculty, we honor Dr. Alice Troop with the President's Medal. Let us congratulate once again all of our emeritus faculty. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of Bridgewater College, Dr. David Bushman.
Well, good morning again, and I'd like to welcome everyone here today again, and thank you again for joining us as we celebrate the accomplishments of our graduates. There's a poem by Marianne Baruch titled, All of Us, All of Us, about resilience in the face of challenge. It reminds us, even when life threatens to undo us, we are not undone. This is what it means to be fully human, to keep moving forward. It's ultimately a message of hope and was very present for me as I wrote this commencement address. First, I want to congratulate the members of the class of 2022. You've done something extraordinary. You have cleared every hurdle put in front of you. Some you knew would be there, but others were completely unexpected. You're ready for your next steps, whatever and wherever they may be. You have every reason to be proud of yourselves, and certainly we could not be more proud of you. The fact that you are sitting here today leads me to a conclusion, one that I am certain we all share. There is no challenge too great for you to overcome. There is nothing you can't do. All that's left now is the doing. So let's get started. Commencement exercises are always very special. It may well be the happiest day of college for the graduates. In many ways, it's the happiest day of the academic year for faculty and staff, not because it represents the end of the year, but because it represents the culmination of all that we hope for, the success of the students who have been so much a part of our lives. It's always a hopeful day because we know the education you have received will empower you to be a source of goodness, of truth, of beauty and harmony in the world. I've participated in over 30 commencement ceremonies now, and they all have much in common: regalia, music, smiles and tears and hugs, and a lot of words. But even though all commencement exercises might look similar, each one is unique. Each one celebrates unique individuals, unique accomplishments, and unique communities. And because this year we're celebrating all of those things in the light of new hope following a tragically dark day, this is a uniquely special commencement. We're celebrating not just your accomplishments, but your resiliency in the face of heartache and our shared strength in a time of turmoil. We are today, more than at any other commencement in the college's history, celebrating our connections and our community. We're recognizing and celebrating your promise, your potential, your capacity for greatness. And we're celebrating the sacrifice and care and commitment of everyone who helped you arrive at this day. We are celebrating all of us. My favorite part of this ceremony comes a little bit later when I hand you your diploma. I get to see each face, shake each hand. I get to see up close the smiles and the excitement and the happiness that are the well-deserved products of your perseverance and accomplishment. For some people, a commencement ceremony might seem to take a very long time. For me, it seems to be over almost as soon as it starts. It's not one long ceremony for me. It's 375 individual joyous celebrations that go by in the blink of an eye. Maybe that's how some of you are thinking about your time here at BC. It seemed like it would go on forever, but it's over before you know it. I know that receiving your diploma is special for you. How could it not be? What makes it special for me is this. In that moment, in those few seconds, when I hand you your diploma and shake your hand, it's not just me congratulating you. I'm representing all those who helped make it possible for you to be here today. Faculty and staff, family and friends, all their work and sacrifice, and all of yours, is focused in that one moment. And I get to be there for it. It's an extraordinary and humbling privilege. And believe me when I tell you that my smile is genuine and that I'm really standing in for all who care about you and all who are celebrating your accomplishment. All of us. I imagine some of you might be wondering why I'm delivering your commencement address. As it turns out, selecting a commencement speaker is not easy. Not because good speakers or well-known figures are necessarily hard to find, but because it's important for our commencement speaker to have a connection to us, to know who we are, know something about the students in the college, to understand our community. Identifying someone who checks those boxes is hard in any year, but for this year, it would have been impossible to find that person by looking outward. It would have been unfair to ask someone to come in from the outside, someone who hasn't lived these last 4 years, these last 4 months with us, and then ask that person to come in and speak to us. And so we looked within. I'm not standing here because I'm the only one who could stand here, but because I'm regularly called upon to speak for our community, it made sense for today for me to speak to our community, all of us. Given the celebrity that surrounds many commencement speakers, it shouldn't be a surprise that many commencement addresses show up on YouTube or in print. I was surprised, though, to discover how much has been written about commencement addresses, what makes some good, what makes some great, and what not to do under any circumstances. I found lists of do's and don'ts, and there was nothing unexpected in those lists. What did strike me about them, though, is that the very same things that make speeches good can also make them flops. Be funny, but not too funny. Be eloquent, but not too formal. Share your perspective, but remember the day is not about you. Everything in moderation, I suppose. But what I didn't find anywhere was advice for how to deal with the worry and the burden of not letting anyone down. Maybe higher profile speakers have this figured out, or maybe it matters less to them because they don't consider their audience family and care about them the way we care about you. Or maybe, since almost no one remembers who their commencement speaker was, much less what that person said, it really doesn't matter. I don't know. It matters a great deal to me because we want this day to be special for you, for us. All of us. Most of the members of the class of 2022 have been here 4 years, some a little less, some a little more, but we have all been through much together in that time. Just this past week, I was looking at old pictures and video from your opening convocation in August of 2018. For the record, that was 1,349 days ago. You walked through a line of cheering faculty and staff dressed in regalia just like they are today. We welcomed you into the BC community that day, and it was the first time you were cheered on by our faculty and staff. And when you leave this ceremony today, you'll walk through a line again and we'll cheer you again. Maybe this will be the last time we do it as a community, but long after you leave this campus, know that we will continue to cheer you on, all of us. I'm sure that for some of you, maybe most of you, these last 1,349 days seem like a lifetime. It can seem like campus has always been just the way you've experienced it, and that it will never change. You've only known the KCC parking lot the way it is today, but it didn't always look like that. We expanded that parking lot in the hectic last days of summer leading up to your arrival on campus in 2018. It seems impossible to believe now, in the light of what we've experienced together, but there was a time when one of our biggest concerns was how many parking spots we had and where we were allowed to park our cars. You've only known the Student Life Suite and the campus store the way they are today, but they too were very different until just before you arrived. You never spent any time in the old Alexander Mack Library. Construction of the four learning commons right across the mall started just as you were graduating from high school. Nothing ever stays the same. Whatever else you've learned on your journey to this day, you've certainly learned that. We all have. I can't begin to know all the ways your lives have changed in these last 1,349 days, but I know that they have. I can't begin to know the details of the success and failures, the joys and sorrows that you've experienced in that time, but I know that you have tasted success and failure, and I know you have experienced joy and sorrow. We all have, all of us. Change is all around us. It has been our constant companion. The pandemic has been a global health tragedy. Lives have been changed forever. Lives have been lost. COVID-19 created new challenges for us, challenges to our economy, challenges to our culture, challenges to the way we live our daily lives. It's also true that the pandemic brought into focus challenges that were already present and accelerated changes already taking place. It magnified things that were already here. That's the nature of a tragedy. But COVID-19 also reminded us of the importance of connections and to take care of ourselves and each other. And maybe that's the nature of a tragedy too. February 1st was a tragedy. Lives were changed forever. Lives were lost. We were forced to confront things we never imagined we would. And as we grieved and healed together, we were reminded of the importance of connections and of the need to take care of ourselves and each other. Our response to that tragedy, the path we walked together, brought into sharp relief the very best qualities in ourselves and in this community. It magnified things that were already here in us, in all of us. In some ways, we've all lived a lifetime over the last 2 years. There was a time when we took many things, even simple things, like greeting each other with a smile every day, for granted. A time when we assumed those things would never change. There was a time when we might have taken for granted the opportunity to be together, to be connected. But not anymore. These past 2 years, we've been tested as a community, as many communities have. These past few months, we've been tested as a community, as few others ever will be. And when we could have come apart, we chose a different path. We came together. We've been attentive to each other's needs, and we have cared for each other. Because we are a family, because our care for each other is as deep as it is genuine, we walked an unbelievably difficult path together. We held another's hand when they needed it because we knew they'd be there for us when we need a hand too. We know things about ourselves we might not have learned any other way. We know that even as we move forward, the sacrifice that John and JJ made for us will not be forgotten. their lives and their sacrifice are now as tightly woven into, as intimate a part of this college's identity as anything ever could be. We're planning a permanent memorial site, and we've established a memorial fund honoring them that's part of the college's endowment, which means that it will be here as long as the college is here. Your class gift is a part of that memorial fund. How could you do anything else? There is no other place your class gift could go. Their memories live in each of us, all of us. In preparing for our Founders Day convocation last month, I was reminded that convocation literally means coming together. That ceremony, much like today's, is a visible sign that we are not alone. We work and play, we laugh and cry, we live and learn together in community. All too recently, we came together to mourn unthinkable loss. Today, we come together to celebrate extraordinary accomplishment, all of us. Your time as a BC student is coming to an end, but as you leave, you're beginning something new. This is truly a commencement. The world you are entering is fraught with challenge. We live in a time of increasingly rapid technological change, breathtakingly more complex than that of just 10 or 20 years ago. A time of developing societies and cries for social justice, of a global economy that often seems to lack foundation, of climate change and vanishing resources, and a time of armed conflict and a global pandemic. None of these challenges, or the many others we face, have simple or easy solutions. None of these problems are one-dimensional. We live in a time in which the challenges we face will only be solved by those who can embed a disciplinary excellence in biology or history or economics or any one of many, many others. Embed that within a context of the connections between disciplines, and people who also have the wisdom to use their talents in service to authentic human goods. This is what a liberal arts education means. Skepticism about the purpose and value of higher education is all around us. Do not be discouraged. Your time here matters. Your degree matters. The challenges we face as local, national, and global communities demand a holistic perspective. They demand the fruits of liberal learning. We need to engage big challenges boldly, but also with humility and a deep understanding of the obligations we have to each other, especially when the other is from a different background or belongs to a different culture or is a member of a future generation. We need to ask not just what can be done and how to do it, but also what ought to be done and how best to do it. This is what your education here at BC has been all about. We know you're prepared to succeed in this challenging world, to make a difference in whatever you do. I want you to feel as confident about this as we do. It won't be easy, but you're ready. Believe in yourself, trust in yourself. Have the courage of your convictions. So what comes next for you, for us? We'll continue educating students just like you. There'll be another first-year class this August and another graduating class next May, and the year after that, and the year after that, and the year after that. That's our job. But we don't do it because it's our job. We do it because it's our vocation, our calling. Vocation is said to be the place where your greatest talents meet the world's greatest needs. Ours is helping you discover and develop your potential. Ours is to help you understand what is and imagine what can be. What will your vocation be? You've done something remarkable here. You've achieved something very special. What will you do with it? Where will you make a difference in the world? How will you make a difference in the lives of others? Don't waste this opportunity. Don't waste all the hard work that got you this far. Don't betray the sacrifices that have been made so that you could reach this moment. You can do great things. We're counting on you to do great things. I haven't had a single quote in this entire commencement address until now. And it's ironic that my only quote will be from Steve Jobs, someone who dropped out of college. Someone who never earned this moment as you have. It's even more ironic, I suppose, that he said these words as part of a commencement address he delivered at Stanford in 2005. He said, "Your work is going to fill a large part of your life. The only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking. Don't settle. As with all matters of the heart, you'll know it when you find it." He got it exactly right. Be truly satisfied. Don't settle. Do great work. Love what you do. That's what's next for you, for us, all of us. Thank you and congratulations.
members of the class of 2022, parents, relatives, and friends, Chairman Christian, President Bushman, trustees, faculty and staff, honored guests. Good morning and welcome to commencement exercises for the class of 2022. As we enter this time of confirmation, allow me to explain the degrees and honors we will be recognizing today. This year's graduates earning the Bachelor of Arts degree may have done so in any 15 of the 27 majors offered at Bridgewater College. For the Bachelor of Science degree, graduates may have completed any one of 12 majors. The class of 2022 has 365 members. 24 students will receive Master of Science degrees. 6 students will earn a Master of Arts degree. 160 of the seniors who are graduating will receive the Bachelor of Arts degree. 175 will receive the Bachelor of Science degree. 119 members of the class will graduate with Latin honors. 56 will graduate cum laude, 36 will graduate magna cum laude, and 27 will graduate summa cum laude. 28 seniors will graduate as members of Bridgewater's honors program, the Florey Honors Program. As explained in your program, some of our graduates are wearing special cords and medals to signify their level of academic achievement and participation at Bridgewater College. In addition, the green ribbons worn by some of our seniors signify that they have signed the graduation pledge of social and environmental responsibility. 2 graduates this morning will receive their diplomas from family members who are or have been faculty of the college. We will begin today by conferring degrees on those students who are candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in the Rhodes School of Arts and Humanities. The Master of Arts in Digital Media Strategy, Danielle Renee Cunningham. Grace Dawn Keller. Mary Sullivan Monaco. Ian P. Rhodes. Samuel Roy Stoner. Ashton Lee Young. From the School of Professional Studies, the Master of Science in Athletic Training, Abel Umiao. Brianna Kiera Blackshear, in absentia. Jessica Nicole McPeak. Rodney Scott Jr. Kaylin Davis Wilder. From the School of Professional Studies, the Master of Science in Human Resource Management, Jusung Chai. Robert Melvin Malik Crow. Morgan Lee Crumpler. Taylor J. Duggar. Dustin A. Green. Tanner Montgomery. Rebecca Lynn Moyer. Jacob O'Brien Murphy. Matthew Edward Myers. Taylor Christine Novak. Denise Massey Smith. From the School of Natural Sciences, Master of Science in Psychology, Cyan Renee Coates. Rachel Nicole Crawford. Kelsey Elizabeth Hicks. Brittany Nicole Linick. Joseph Dwayne Schwarzentruber. Aaron P. Vogley. Benjamin Paige Williams. From the Rhodes School of Arts and Humanities, Bachelor of Arts, C.J. Allen Jr. Catherine Grace Baker, magna cum laude. Adrielle L. Benner, summa cum laude, flori honors in absentia. Savannah Nakuavi Blake. Alexis Marie Bragg. Valerie L. Brown. Jared Brown, magna cum laude, flori honors. Mackenzie Rose Bryant. Trinity Michelle Bumbry. Macaulay L. Calhoun, magna cum laude, flori honors. Benjamin Michael Chatterton, summa cum laude, flori honors in absentia. Kiana Cherry. Emma N. Klaus. Taylor Sierra Corbin. Alexander H. Cromwell. Nigeia Ariel Krul. Brooke Mahela DeChico. Nathan A. Douglas, cum laude. Ashley Christina Dupree, cum laude. Kevin Nathaniel Epps. Wilcon Glay. Alicia K. Gomez. Nijay Taeja Griffin. Hannah Grace Hawkins. Samantha K. Hintz, summa cum laude, Flory honors, in absentia. Brittany H. Irwin. Susan D. Jenkins, cum laude. Valencia Elizabeth Jimenez, cum laude. Jaden Alexander Johnson, cum laude. Cassie Elise Jordan. Davin Parker Kynes, cum laude. Mason Paul King. Nina Rochelle King, summa cum laude. Jacqueline Dadegyung, cum laude. Kylie A. Lorio, magna cum laude, Flory honors. Christina Lynn Ludwig. Alicia Marie McCarthy. Isaac M. Miller. Kalia Nicole Page, magna cum laude. Morgan Asher Pengel, magna cum laude. Rihanna Victoria Power, magna cum laude. Charles Hilliard Price, summa cum laude. Xaviera Pride. Kendra Gabrielle Ristola, magna cum laude. Carla Yanira Rivera. Walter Dean Robb. Juan Francisco Romero. Noah Matthew Ross, in absentia. Erin Michelle Ryder. Jennifer Santiago Cruz, cum laude. Alexander Patrick Schwinn. Yasmin Sebti. Jeffrey B. Shackelford. Yifan Cheng. Destiny Faith Shoemaker, summa cum laude. Amaya Renee Smith, cum laude. Caitlin Nicole Smith. Amber L. Smoot. Michaela C. Sonnefrank, magna cum laude. Madison L. Stearns, cum laude. Carson Beckwith Stevens. Carson's diploma is being given to him by his father, the retired math instructor and head track coach, Shane Stevens. Sienna E. Sullivan, magna cum laude. Anna Elizabeth Suter. Anna's diploma is being given to her by her father, Dr. Scott Suter, professor of English. Cecily L. Tusing, cum laude. Deborah Wakilongo. Melissa N. Wilson, cum laude. Emily A. York. Katya Isabella Zablocki, summa cum laude, Flory honors, in absentia. Nadezhda G. Zoteva. From the Rhodes School of Arts and Humanities, the Bachelor of Science. Hanley Scott Carpenter, magna cum laude. Jordan Davis, cum laude. Capricia K. Evans. Taylor Ferguson. Zachary L. Gray. Diamond Husky, cum laude. Mark James, cum laude. Ariana C. Jones. Jemima Mbuyi Matala. Kevin Jovan Navedo Claudio. Reginald Maurice Patterson III, magna cum laude, in absentia. Leighton Alexander Pullen, cum laude. Kyle Allen Sterrett, cum laude. Tyler Michael Tabor. Patrick Tiffy. Jillian Rose Wall. Jalissa Renee White Jones. Shane Michael Williamson, cum laude. From the School of Professional Studies, the Bachelor of Arts. Noemi Acosta, cum laude. Ryan Ash Pohl.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Katie Elizabeth Austin. Hunter J. Becker. Noah Christopher Beckley. Abigail Marissa Brown, magna cum laude. Colin Michael Bryant. Jaden Corey Bynum. Cole Evan Cooksey. Mark Randolph DeWitt. Erin Marie Dietz, summa cum laude, Flory honors, in absentia. Bethany Shea Eldred. Kelly Elizabeth Ennis, magna cum laude. Samuel J.B. Estep. In absentia. Bailey Ferguson, cum laude. Tyler Fink, magna cum laude. McPherson Ahmad Fry. Michael Patrick Golinowski, magna cum laude, Flory honors. Pamela Gonzalez Encina. Jacob Howard Graybeal. Ayana Nichelle Graves. Preston Hayden. Kinley Brooke Hambrick. Katie Elizabeth Hardy. Kaya Renee Harris. Zachary Brian Hedrick. Victoria Diane Hertenstein. Samuel Zane Homick. Alston Honeycutt. Tucker Rasky. Joshua James Huffman. Fletcher Connor Jackson, summa cum laude, Flory honors. Emily Grace Jenks. Lucas Johnson. Charles E. Jones. Matthew Robert Lawton. Sydney Addison Lehman. Eric Leisner. Davon Lee. Kayla Lee Loki, magna cum laude. Canandez Lee Lawrence Long. Kelly Lynn McGill, magna cum laude. Christopher Michael Martell, cum laude. Griffin Lee Maynard, cum laude, in absentia. Gracie Irene McClure, summa cum laude. Jennifer Joanna Melendez, summa cum laude. Chance Morrison. Andrew Nicholas Murphy. Amanda Paige Nesselrott. Robert Noyes, cum laude. Anthony J. Organ. Anderson Gregory Pack. Haley Nicole Partlow. Courtney Peak, magna cum laude. Renee Christine Palome. Hannah Frialde Randolph, cum laude. Grayson A. Retch. Robert Evans Resch III, cum laude. Naomi Portia Reynolds. Virginia Lynn Ritter, summa cum laude. Canon Secord, in absentia. Emily Sanger. Magna cum laude. Courtney Seymour, summa cum laude. Danielle Francis Schenk. Ryan Taylor Shepherd. Logan Michael Shiflett. Tori Lee Shiflett. Robert Michael Stoss III. Charles H. Street. Andrea Nicole Tirado Rivera. Jacob Gray Tomlin. Joshua E. Trapp. Robert Marshall Tucker. Nadia Vallee, in absentia. Christian Alexander Vames. John Vetter. Karan Laetitia Volel. Dexter William Paul Walker, cum laude. Lexia Sky Werner, magna cum laude, Flory honors. Melody Alexandra White. Cameron Bennett Williams. Sarah Elizabeth Weimer, cum laude. From the School of Professional Studies, Bachelor of Science, Abigail Jane Allen, cum laude. Giovanni Alonso Ardalan. Benjamin Armstrong. Jenna Claire Ashley. Yeah! Jelani Tai Bacchus. Chandler Branch, summa cum laude, in absentia. Richard Layton Lawrence Butler. Savannah Lynn Kaysen. Tyler McChristian Kale. Colin Alexander Carpenter, magna cum laude. Haley Catherine Clark, cum laude. Michael Joseph Clift. Miles Conley, in absentia. Deshaun Antonio Davis. Alyssa Ronnie Dodrill, cum laude. Anna Elson. Samari Saheed Eppinger. Daniela M. Espinosa Hernandez. Lauren G. I. Richard Wingfield Flournoy III. Samuel Koss Franklin. Cameron F. Giesman. Annalise Medell Grove. Brooke Mackenzie Ham. Timothy Lauren Hobson. Demetrius M. Gilleps, in absentia. Hope Elizabeth Jennings, summa cum laude. Leslie Yamilet Hoya. Matthew Douglas Kiley. Olivia Louise Kloster, cum laude, Flory Honors. Jenna Long. Alexis Danielle Mackey, cum laude. Tiara Madera. Jasmine N. Mann. Andrew Zachary Moss. Andrew J. Meechan. Zoe Elizabeth Moore. Alicia Mariana Morehouse. Caleb Sydney Needle. Mayan Trung Nguyen, summa cum laude. Avery Elizabeth Pinder, cum laude. Lauren Kathleen Pine. Logan Ray Poff. Caroline Elizabeth Quigley. Valeria Santos Esteban. Lauren Elizabeth Shippa. Taylor Simone Miola Stafford. Lily Elizabeth Stonecipher. Sydney Elizabeth Sutton, magna cum laude. Malachi William Terrell. Caitlin Amber Torona. Bryce Marquise Tonia. Casey Marie Truslow, cum laude. Brandon Javon Waller. Sierra A. Warham, cum laude. Allison Brooke Wilhoit. Isaiah James Williams. Lindsay Elizabeth Winkles, cum laude. Hannah Grace Woodson. Trifina Yakubu. Shay Jordan Yoder, cum laude. Caroline Jane Zimmerman, cum laude. From the School of Natural Sciences, Bachelor of Arts, Nobel Duress Abdul Qadir. Benjamin Allen Dillon, cum laude. Heather Donnelly. Autumn Marie Flickinger. Michaela Johnson. Christina Caitlin Allen Rexrode. Tiandriana Cherie Williams. Jacob Dalton Zimmerman. From the School of Natural Sciences, Bachelor of Science, Kelly Ann Akers, cum laude. Colton Lane Allison, magna cum laude. Sarah Ann Autry. Doreen Ibrahim Awad, cum laude. Taylor Joyce Banton, cum laude, Flory Honors. Sarah Marie Ben Asher. Jordan Lee Bennett, cum laude. Jacobus Robert Bentley, cum laude. Jessica Lynn Bismeyer. Yeah. Anissa Lee Boyers. Samantha Marie Brooks. Jonathan Rolston Brubaker, cum laude. Bonnie B. Buchanan, in absentia. Justin W. Cairns, magna cum laude. Trent Cheney. Kylie Elizabeth Chisnell, magna cum laude, Flory Honors. Abigail Elizabeth Crawford, cum laude. Caroline M. Crowder. Sydney Andrea Davis. Kaylee Nicole Dean. Luis Daniel Del Real Alvarez. Chase T. Dube. Caitlin Ashley Drake. Felicia L. Earl. Natalie Jane Ellis, cum laude, Flory Honors. Angel L. Finch. McKenna Catherine Franklin. Pablo Francisco Fuentes Ramirez. Sydney Marie Gunnan. Matthew Stephen Gordon, summa cum laude, Flory Honors. Meredith Paige Goss. Wyatt Barrick Hall. Benjamin Parker Hancock, summa cum laude, Flory Honors, in absentia. Daniel Reese Hancock, summa cum laude, Flory Honors, in absentia. Benjamin C. Hanks, summa cum laude, Flory Honors, in absentia. Kara Elise Helbert, cum laude. Ashley Nicole Hendricks. Hunter Christian James. Amna Abid Khan, in absentia. Ian Moore LaValle. Angel Unique Labu. Chris Lynn Larson, magna cum laude. Brittany P. Law. Lexi May Lees, cum laude. Alexandra M. Lightenfield. Kelsey Ann Listman, summa cum laude, Flory Honors. Brooke Nicole Locagio, magna cum laude, Flory Honors. Quentin Victor Long. Tyler W. Lynn, summa cum laude, Flory Honors. William Alexander Mikowski. Aaron Joe Martlock, in absentia. Bryce Masters, cum laude. Jordan Mackenzie Matthews, magna cum laude. Catherine Lois Marie Maddox. Jameson Dylan Meadows. Mariah Meganson. Yumna K. Mawad, summa cum laude. Laura Elizabeth Moore. Erica Monique Nettles. Stormy Danielle Knuckles. Haley Nicole Orbaugh, cum laude. Ashlyn Brooke Patterson. Lane P. Phillips, magna cum laude, Flory Honors. Delilah Marie Prybilski. Grace Jinfa Riley, magna cum laude, Flory Honors. Andrew Jonathan Robinson. Cameron Paige Rosenberger. Chase Jacob Rosenthal. Julia Bree Russell. Carolyn I. Schreider. Jagger L. Schutt, cum laude. Harrison Williams Center, magna cum laude, Flory Honors, in absentia. Madison Caitlin Sessoms, cum laude. Colin Sharps, magna cum laude. Era Shehu, summa cum laude. Lauren T. Smith. LaJoya Janae Stith. Luke Nicholas Stubbs, cum laude. David Austin Sullivan. Cassie Maria Taylor, magna cum laude. Liliana Catherine Thousand, cum laude. Jessica Lynn Tuvey, magna cum laude, Flory Honors. Lyric Elizabeth May Updike, in absentia. Rebecca Joy Vaughn, in absentia. Cheyenne Taylor L. Villarosa, cum laude. Donna Guyani Warna Kulasuria. Tyrone Darnell Warren II. Yeah. Joshua Keith Whittington. Jonathan North Williams, summa cum laude, Flory Honors. Matthew H. Williams. Lauren Nicole Whitmer, summa cum laude, Flory Honors. Courtney Alexandra Yancey. Brittany Nicole Young, summa cum laude. Would the members of the class of 2022 please stand? I invite you to move your tassels from the right side of your caps to the left side. President Bushman, on behalf of an affirming vote by the faculty of Bridgewater College, I have the distinct honor of presenting the Bridgewater College class 2022 candidates for degrees and honors, as so indicated in the commencement program.
Thank you, Provost Sevick. Upon the favorable action of the faculty and under the authority of the Board of Trustees vested in me as president of Bridgewater College, I hereby confer upon you so presented the degree of Master of Science, the degree of Master of Arts, the degree of Bachelor of Arts, and the degree of Bachelor of Science, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto and appertaining. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2022, congratulations. You can all be seated. We have just a couple of more minutes. But you get to clap again. Members of the class of 2022, you are rightfully the center of our attention today. But remember, you are not the only ones celebrating. Also deserving of congratulations, recognition, and praise are all of those who have given you encouragement and support. To that end, I would ask you to always remember and to thank your families and friends, faculty and staff, everyone who made it possible for you to be here today. You've been through much together. We've been through much together, all of us. There have been good times and hard times, many things that were familiar and expected, and others that were unfamiliar and shockingly unexpected. None of us could have predicted a global pandemic, or the events of February 1st and the ways our lives have been altered because of it. But the fact that we are here today is testament to your resiliency, to the power of community, to the willingness to do hard things and work together to achieve something that none of us could have done alone. These things won't show up on your transcript, you weren't graded on them, but they are among the most important things you've learned. They are the experiences, the lessons, the habits of mind that can be a source of great strength and that you can rely on for the rest of your life. The path to this day has not been an easy one. If it were, the accomplishment would mean much less. Thomas Paine said, "What we obtain too cheap, we esteem too little. It is dearness only that gives everything its value." Despite the challenges you faced, you persevered and earned your degrees. What marks you as worthy of those degrees is not just the knowledge you've accumulated, but the wisdom to apply that knowledge in service to authentic human goods, in service to others. You are empowered to live lives of purpose and consequence, and in so doing, you will honor all the hard work, all the sacrifices that went into making this day possible. And now that you have received your diplomas and had your degrees officially conferred, it's my honor to welcome you as our newest alumni and declare you to be now and forever sons and daughters of Bridgewater College. Go Eagles. Congratulations, class of 2022. We'll conclude, as we always do, with the singing of the college song, Bridgewater Fair, led by the senior members of the college choir. I'd ask you to stand and please join in. The words can be found on the inside back cover of your program. Please remain standing following the college song for the benediction to be offered by Reverend Miller.
So as you move beyond these familiar walls and storied halls of Bridgewater College, may you have community to ground you, resiliency to sustain you, courage to strengthen you, hope to inspire you, and may you mount up with wings like the eagles you are and make of this world a better place for all of us. Go in peace. Amen.
I now declare the 142nd commencement exercises of Bridgewater College closed.